Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, you wanted to go, but let's some text B-roll.
Did you need to text the
EDM? Yes, I will go. Sure. So now our guide is here. And we are just near. Everywhere you see the mountain. You see? Oh my god. Oh my goodness. Beauty. Now we have a small boat here. Nile Basin. Discourse. Another story.
It was not just to find the. This was after how many years he built this pyramid.
But the stone from Burundi, everything is from Burundi.
No, yeah. The cement. I remember you told us the story about the cement.
We are using Simba cement here. Simba cement?
And this plaque. And this was very hard to find.
Yes.
It came from Congo, actually.
Yes, please explain.
Okay. So the name of the one, the explorer, was Dr. Burkhard Waldecker. Yeah, he's a German.
Dr. Burkhard Waldecker.
Yeah.
He's a Roman, eh?
German.
German. German. German explorer.
Explorer, yes. Yeah. Hani hamana la do na mne da bugarel an egypt yari hali hani kil bahal el abyadinil.
Okay, Egypt. So this is the
river, eh?
No, the sea where he was, or the lake where he was when he was still in Nile before he start the trip coming to Burundi.
Start from there.
Yeah, it was called the Bahr el Abyadinil.
Kir Bahar Bal Abed.
Nil.
Oh my god. It's not a difficult name.
Yes.
Sudan du Nord. We are rencontré le lac qu'on appelle Bahr el Jebel.
Bahar al-Jabal.
So this is the name of the lake that he found in the north of Sudan.
Sudan north.
Yeah, Bahar al-Jabal.
Et voilà. Au Sudan du Sud, il y a le lac al-Bel ou Mitanzige, parce qu'il y a le lac entre le Congo et l'Ouganda.
Yeah, and this is the name of the lake he found in the south Sudan.
South Sudan,
eh? Bon, il y a l'Ouganda. Il y a le lac Kyoga, le Victoria Nil en Ouganda.
Yeah. In Uganda, he found Lake Kyoga and Victoria
Nil.
So Victoria there Nil. Are many sources of Nil, eh?
Yeah.
Including Rwanda, Burundi, and Uganda,
Tanzania.
And Tanzania.
Lake Victoria.
Yes.
Even the Sudan.
So in Tanzania, he found Victoria,
Rwanda, etc.
Yeah, you see the name Kagera in Rwanda,
but Burundi or not?
Yeah, Ruvubu, you found Ruvu in the north of Burundi.
And he
found Ruvirose also in the center of Burundi.
Yeah,
from 5 kilometers from here, Kigira River, and at 2 kilometers, Kasenyi. And the place where we just left is called Kasumo. That's what the name. Kasumo, which means the source.
Yeah, the living source.
Après tu vois alors découvert la source la plus loin de là à la Kasumo. Là les matières après faire quoi? Il cette pyramide au sommet de cette crête.
So he decided to build this pyramid now that you can
symbol,
see here
the symbol.
As a symbol of that source of Nile.
Source of Nile and also pay the tribute to Dr. Burkhard Waldecker.
So it's also in his memory.
Now we are in Egypt. Now we are in Egypt. You see the pyramid here. This is very historical place. Even we don't know. We are living in Burundi. We don't know about this. Now, Mr. Patrick.
So he brought this plaque that you can see in copper. I think it is made in copper.
Ah, la langue latine.
Yeah. So as you can see, it's written in Latin language.
Caputi. Qu'est-ce qu'il a écrit? Pyramidis ad Caputi Nil. En français, veut dire la pyramide à la tête du Nil.
Yeah, so it's written in Latin, mm-hmm. Pyramides
ad caput nihili. La pyramide à la tête.
So which means the pyramid at the head of the source of life.
Voilà. Mary Dio, this pyramid is situated on the head of source of the Nile.
Yeah.
Voilà, méridional ici moment, ça veut dire la plus méridionale. So, ça veut dire la source la plus au sud du Nil.
And meridionalissimum, which means the southernmost
so Nile source.
The one
is it in Burundi
la
only?
La plus meridionale, la plus au sud.
This is original source of the Nile. White Nile.
Parce qu'il existe plusieurs sources du Nil, mais la source la plus méridionale, la plus au sud. Ça se trouve ici au Burundi.
Yeah.
À la Kasumala, on venait de quitter.
Yeah, because
cette pyramide,
as you mentioned, there is a lot of sources of Nile. But the southernmost is this one. And it's
alors,
that place where.
Cette pyramide est le symbole de la source.
Yeah. So the pyramid is a symbol of the source.
Voilà. Akaga phrase n'a pas eu à Et voilà, donc cette pyramide est également le symbole du débit du fleuve ou débit le fleuve Nil blanc. Parce qu'il existe deux fleuves Nil. Il y a le fleuve Nil blanc et le fleuve Nil bleu. Mm. La source du blanc, c'est ici au Burundi. La source du blanc, c'est
Blue Nile is in Ethiopia.
C'est ici au Burundi. La source du blanc, ça se trouve en Éthiopie. Yes. Les deux fleuves se rencontrent où? Au Soudan, au nord, à Khartoum.
Ah, okay. Mm. So he also say that this is the source of the White Nile.
White Nile. Yes.
Because there is a source of Blue Nile, which is in Ethiopia, and the two meet in the north of Sudan.
Sudan. Khartoum.
Yeah, Khartoum. Yes.
Voilà.
That's where they meet.
L'Allemand a quitté l'Égypte en 1930. Il est arrivé ici en 1934.
So he left Egypt in 1830, and he arrived here in 1834.
34, almost 4 years.
Il a construit cette pyramide en 1938. Ça, erect, en français, veut dire érigé. 1938, chiffre romain du collection.
Oh, it's 900, not
1800.
Not 1800. That is. So he built this pyramid in 800. It's 1934. 38.
So they reach here 1934.
Yeah, so after 4 years.
After 4 years, they build this pyramid, in the symbol of.
Hello. So, why does it take to
cook our
fashion like in
it?
Okay. He's explaining why it took 4 years.
Yeah. L'Allemand n'avait pas de moyens.
So it took him 4 years because he didn't have money to build this.
Il devait recourir à certaines autorités, à certains gens pour construire cette pyramide.
Yeah, so he was looking for some sponsorship from the local authorities.
Bouke franga tayari bado.
Et le premier qui a aidé, c'était qui? Le premier qui a aidé, c'était un prêtre, un berger. Qui était gouverneur Rwanda aujourd'hui en 1934? Il s'appelait comme ça Julius.
Ah, so there is the first authority who accepted to help him is Jungels, who was the governor of Burundi.
Governor of Burundi.
Rwanda and Burundi at the time, because it was a part of the Congo and Rwanda Burundi as a colonial region.
Qu'est-ce qu'il a aidé? Il a aidé à lui assurer sa protection physique.
Alors, his support was specially to give to provide security for him.
Security
physical for him. Security.
Okay.
Because he was not safe.
Qui a aidé, c'était qui? C'était un prêtre belge qui s'appelait comme ça.
Because everyone is claiming at that time.
Il était belge aussi.
The other guy who was a Belgian is the Father Cole.
Qu'est-ce qu'il a aidé? Il a aidé à lui fournir ses pierres, du sable, du marron. Pour construire cette pyramide.
The big blocks.
So the guy provided him the stones that you see to build this pyramid.
Yes.
Alors, qu'est-ce que l'Allemand a écrit encore sur la plaque? L'Allemand a écrit que c'est lui-même qui a découvert la source, la plus méridionale du Nil. Alors qu'il y avait d'autres explorateurs qui ont essayé de chercher la tête du Nil, mais qui n'ont pas réussi.
So he wrote also that he's the one who discovered this source of Nile.
Il a cité deux Grecs, deux Anglais et un Allemand.
Mm. So he cited also the name of people who tried to find the source of Nile,
but they did
without
not.
Success.
Without success, they failed.
Le premier grec qui a essayé, qui a échoué, il s'appelait comme ça, Eratosthène.
So the first one was Eratosthène.
L'autre, il s'appelait Ptolémée.
And another one was Ptolémaeus.
Les deux Anglais, le premier s'appelait Speke.
Yeah, there was Speke.
L'autre s'appelait Stanley.
And Stanley.
Kant, il était allemand.
And there's Kant, who was a German.
Et d'autres.
And Many more.
But Mr. Dr. Burkett,
he's the one who found
Waldecker. He found this source of the Nile.
Finally, yeah. Yeah, so he was a very courageous.
Courageous German guy.
So he left Burundi going to Katanga, just walking to Congo.
Because he was going to look for something.
But this time when he went to Congo, there were some Burundian from this area who went with him.
Okay.
So it was a delegation.
Un
chef parmi eux est appelé Nivianol. Il était chef d'une équipe de 16 personnes qui ont accompagné l'Allemand vers le Congo.
So there was among those Burundian a guy who was called Nivianol. He was a chief and he has a team of 16 people who went with the German guy.
Il allait faire quoi? Il allait demander l'aide matérielle à ses amis allemands qui travaillait dans une société qu'on appelait Géomine, un projet de changement de nos villes, Géomine, quoi, il trouve.
Yeah, so he was going to look for other Germans who worked in Congo, and they were working in a company called Géomine. Geomines, but which became later Gécamines, one of the biggest company in DRC doing mining.
Voilà, en lui fournissant alors 5 sacs de ciment.
So those people from Congo, he got just 5 sacks of cement.
Yes, 5 sacks.
Yeah. Only 5.
Et à lui fabriquer cette plaque sur laquelle est écrite l'histoire.
And they made this plaque for him.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, oh, and then they wrote on it.
They wrote something that is the whatever the history you have to explore there.
Chose encore étonnante, la plaque.
And this is, I think, metallic, hein? This is metallic.
It's in copper. Made in copper.
Voilà. Cette plaque,
it is made
que
in copper.
Elle est fabriquée dans une matière très lourde, le cuivre.
Yeah.
Elle pèse plus de 50 kg.
So this plaque, although it looks smaller, it weighs 50 kilos.
50 kilograms.
Yes.
Yeah. Mais
because the material is very heavy.
Oh, mais chose encore étonnante, la plaque que vous voyez ici, but elle a été emportée sur la tête de nos arrière grands-pères depuis Katanga. Jusqu'ici, avec les 5 sacs de ciment.
So, from Katanga, people brought it on their head.
In their head, up to here.
Along with the
ils
cement.
Ils ont passé plus d'une année à route.
Yeah, so they spent one whole year on the road coming.
Coming.
So those are our forefathers who were coming.
Alors, pourquoi l'histoire est
écrite? We have a lot of respect of those guys.
Pourquoi l'histoire est écrite là?
It's not easy.
So, why the story is written in Latin?
Yes.
Lorsqu'il est arrivé ici, il avait amené une tente, il vivait dans une tente.
So when he came here, he was living in a tent somewhere here.
La tente par après a été déchirée, on a construit une petite maison à paille.
So because of the time he spent here, the tent was destroyed. Then they built him a house using So he's suffering from I don't know how to explain that. Yeah, but he was suffering
diseases,
from
some diseases.
So the Burundian people around, they gave him a name, which is Rukwabagara.
Yeah.
So they were not able to pronounce the name. So they just tried to find something which was close to his name. So they say Rukwabagara.
It's like
le dimanche il aimait aller à la prière à l'église catholique de Rutovu, c'est à 6 km d'ici.
Yeah, so he liked to go to church in Rutovu, which is at 6 km from here.
Arrivé là à l'église. So,
At the time, all Burundians celebrated the mass in Latin.
Yes.
So he thought in his mind that all Burundians were speaking Latin. So that's why he wrote in Latin.
Et la plaque que vous voyez ici, elle est fabriquée au Congo Oussa dans l'union minière du Haut-Katanga.
So yeah, the plaque was made in the mining union of Haut-Katanga, which is, I think, it is still called Katanga.
Katanga.
Many things are written here. Yeah. They're written later, they're written before.
No, it's just
Doctor, you're a historian. Mais en dehors de son doctorat, il avait fait une formation connexe de la maçonnerie, de l'architecture.
Ah.
C'est so lui qui a construit cette pyramide à ses propres mains.
So he was a historian. Mm. He has a doctorate in history, mm-hmm. but he was also trained as an architect. Okay. So he's the one who did the concept mm-hmm. of all the pyramid, how it should
how it look like.
L'entrée chez Tumbeza Mulino.
So this is the entrance which looks to the north.
This is the north area.
So if you have a compass and yes. you put it here, it will show you the north.
I can show. I have a mobile. I have a compass. I can see.
So, yes.
This is the north.
Ah, so you inside can you can see some this. Windows, which means the funeral of the pharaoh.
Yes, there are some windows here.
For example, the Et ça, quand tu tombes, le pyramide d'Égypte,
c'est
Khéops, mm-hmm. qui atteignait avant 146 mètres de hauteur, actuellement 138. Pour une base de 230 mètres, si vous entrez à l'intérieur de la pyramide, vous allez voir un pharaon enterré à l'intérieur de la pyramide avec encore momifié.
Mm.
Les grands pharaons.
Yeah, normally if you enter into the pyramid, yeah, you'll find
the
mummy. So, that's the story.
Mummy's inside?
No, here there's no mummy. It was just summarizing.
Okay. You have to go to Pyramid Egypt.
No.
They're in the museum.
So, you can bring the car here for the picnic now.
Okay. So that's it.
Okay.
Patrick, that's it.
Yeah, that's it. So now you enjoy the picture. You can make the pictures.
Yeah.
No, I'm going to bring the car. So do some pictures.
This is the pyramid on the head of source of the Nile, Burundi. Now the history time is finished and you can see we are going to take some food. Now the picnic time is start. And people are coming and join, and then we are going to eat here. This is our car. These are the people. We came with all our tools. Now we have to. See, this lady is working hard. There is some drinks, there is some soft drinks, sandwiches, many things are there. You have to enjoy even the water. What is inside? Let me see. Oh, there's a salad, there's a watermelon. And Patrick is also doing hard work. Goza, let me come. Where is the gate? Best day ever.
Oh.
Today in Burundi, yes. I must say, best day ever.
Oh, I'm happy that you're enjoying.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
So, wow, here everyone. We have some ice. If you want to get some ice.
Yes.
Yeah, already ice around.
Yes.
some bananas, some orange, some salad, some sandwich. Okay, I'm going to stop the video here.
So you can have some drink.